Antifungal drug research is clearly a very important area for now and for the future. We have antifungal drugs, but it's fair to say there's nothing quite as broad spectrum or as effective as some of the drugs we use to treat bacteria. One of the great challenges for the next 20, 30, 40 years is antimicrobial drug resistance. And unfortunately, from the perspective of somebody like myself who works in mycology, that term AMR is often taken to mean just bacteria. And you may say, well, maybe there is no problem with drug resistance against fungi, but this is not the case. And in fact, this is a very important area, again covered in this book. For example, Aspergillus drug resistance has increased significantly over the last 10, 20 years. And there's the worry that the increase in resistance is being driven not in the hospital, but actually in agricultural fields, because some of the classes of antifungals which are used to treat crop diseases cross-react and are the same general classes which we also have to use in a hospital. So you can get a drug-resistant fungus in the field, the spores can get into a hospital setting. This is a concern. We also now know in recent years that are emerging pathogens. One very notable example is Candida auris, first really recognized in 2009 in Japan and now present endemically around the world. Candida auris is an example of a very often multiply drug-resistant organism. Some strains, in fact, resistant to the three major classes which we use to treat fungal infections. A very serious scenario. So it is absolutely not the case that we do not have to worry about drug resistance for fungi. We have a number of classes of agent, not enough, not with the ideal spectrum of properties as yet, and we have to protect and look after them because drug resistance is a significant problem for many species.